So in this book, I was trying to enter as many different minds as I could, as I tried to understand, you know, what is it that's so haunting about this weapon? What is it that's so eerie? So one of the things I wanted to think about was what it was like to be the troops underneath the drones, because the drone pilots were really clinging to this idea that they were like guardian angels, that they were traditional air support, that they were supporting the people on the ground. So then I spent this poem thinking about what it was like to be in a transport vehicle on the ground with the drones out. Transport. Between twilight and twilight, the muddled sleep of fear with a head against a stranger's shoulder. Every bomb, every bullet is coming towards you, every hand holding a detonator, a jolt in the road, and it's all over. Where am I? A battlefield is home compared to that place. Then it's day. A buddy is sprawled on the bench seat, mouth raw, agape, tenderness. Maybe bombs are outside waiting, but here a bit of morning comes through dirt-smudged windows. The driver swigs coffee from a flask. He's driven all night while you slept helpless. A flood of thanks before thinking at the back of his head. The windshield is full of blue sky. The drones will be out, Bethlehem stars, clearing the way. You let the thanking in, the melt where fear was, blood warm. Give in to it, like you give in to the truck shake through your bones, like whiskey. Let it soak your parched ground.